Part two, putting in the outer seal. I believe it goes in like that. And of course I don't have a perfectly fitting cup like this to hammer it down. So more improvisation. And we will just kind of press it down like that. Tuck your little brass punch. Give it a little tap, tap, tap. Tap, tap. Let's try that again. Yeah, it's going to be squirrely. It's going to be squirrely doing it this way. And maybe if I hold it down on this side with my palm of my hand, I can get it to slip in there. This is a tough one. It's a little rough too. There's a little rust around the lip of the hub, which could be keeping it from sliding down. I may have to sand that down a little bit. Yeah, it's a little rough in there. I think we just need to do it this way. Feels like it just wants to go and then it just pops out on me. Okay, let's try this. Let's just do it like use a little bit more different, a little bit more edginess. Okay, seems like it wants to go in right there. Yeah, it's going in now. We got it. We got it now. Doesn't have to be perfect. Any way you can get it in there, right? And using the palm of your hand on the back side of it helps give you more leverage for those tight fitting ones. Look at that. No problem. There it is. Okay. Now, now I want to get that hub in, so I'm going to do that the same way. that we put the bearing in. And we need to hold, we need to put a spacer block in here like that to hold that inner race in there like that. Just like that. Yeah. And there's a brand new hub made in China. Slip ring is holding the bearing in on the bottom side, so we're not going to push the bearing out. Just like that. That looks pretty good, pretty well balanced, level. And the bolt is right there. Maybe slipped off here. Okay. And we'll do the same routine like so. Everything's lubed with the red tacky. Slip that baby right in there. looks like it's in there. Call that good. Yeah, seals up against it, the back of it, so that looks good.